There are 800,000 strokes per year in the United States. 200,000 of those are left with disability. As stroke coordinators, we educate the community on stroke, and it's evident. We see patients coming in sooner with their symptoms. The nurses and physicians throughout Franciscan are all trained in caring for stroke patients, which also helps reducing the long-term disability of stroke. The way to remember the stroke signs and symptoms is using FAST. Facial droop, arm or leg weakness, speech problems, and then T would be for time. Time to call 911. Don't get in the car and try to drive. It's time to call 911. They know where to take you.
Our goal as a first responder is to minimize the time on scene for a patient exhibiting signs and symptoms of stroke. When arriving on scene, the first things that we want to do is establish a timeline. We'll then do a patient interview and establish a baseline set of vital signs, then transition from their house to getting them to the emergency department as soon as possible. We'll establish medical treatments as needed and let the emergency department know that we have a code neuro coming so they can get the medical team ready and their people in the right place.
Before a patient arrives at the hospital, we'll get a call from EMS notifying us that a stroke patient is on their way. They are quickly assessed in the emergency department by a team of personnel, which include nursing staff, technicians, and a physician. In a stroke patient, time is of the utmost importance. Any second or minute that we can save helps open up more windows of opportunity for treatment. When we're assessing a patient, we're looking to see what level of deficit that they have, meaning what level of functioning that they're no longer able to do. We'll look at their strength, we look at their ability to speak, we look at their ability to open and close their eyes. The patient is then quickly taken to the CAT scanner, usually within 10 minutes of arrival in the emergency department to get further evaluation of their brain.
Patients who have stroke, that have blood clots in their head that are blocking blood flow, have the option of having a procedure in this room done. Basically, the procedure involves going inside their blood vessel and removing that blood clot physically. After treatment here, patients are routinely transferred to the neurointensive care unit upstairs for further care. The nurses there have additional training and additional expertise in taking care of stroke patients, regardless of the severity.
When we receive a patient from neurointerventional radiology, we provide one-on-one care to make sure that their alertness and their orientation is improving and not declining. Time is very important. We do a careful, close observation for over 24 hours. We educate the patient and the family the plan of care and what they can expect for the rest of our shift and their monitoring. The goal is to get them back to what they were before their stroke happened, so back to their baseline of being able to do what they could do, get dressed, eat, walk around, drive their car, walk their dog.
As a stroke victim, your job is to get to the hospital fast. Call 911. Our job is to provide the best quality care. We make sure patients who have strokes are able to live afterwards, have a better life afterwards.